Hello and welcome. My name is Manuel Quintana with Pragmatic Works, and in collaboration with MAQ Software, we're bringing you today's video to explore the Quadrant Chart. This is pretty much going to be a bubble chart, but it allows us to section out the pieces of the bubble chart into four different areas, really easily allowing us to get understandings of relationships between those various data points that are being plotted, right? So if something falls into quadrant two in the upper left corner, that's going to very easily and quickly give us a fast understanding of the data, depending on what metrics we have placed on the X and or the Y axis. Not only that, we can add a third value there, a third measure to show size of the bubbles, right? So to further explore this, of course, let's head over to Power BI so we can look at the quadrant chart. So here we are looking at the quadrant chart. And as we can see, we're looking at some data that represents manufacturers. And we're looking at how many total units they've sold, what is their sales amount that they've sold. And we still haven't used the radial axis yet, but that is what is going to allow us to dictate the size of the actual bubble. So for us, so we can fully see this fleshed out, let's go ahead and take our total units year-to-date sold, and we'll bring that into the radial axis area, which we now we can see it breaks it down. Naturally, the larger the bubble, the more total units have been sold. So as we break this down, let's look at the different formatting options that we have at our disposal. We go right over to this section. We can see that we can control naturally the legend, if it should appear or should it not, what orientation, where should it be positioned, and naturally the size, color that we would like for it to show up as. Beyond that though, if we wanted, we could actually turn this into a bubble chart just by turning off this quadrant option. But this is all about giving us the capability of labeling and displaying, hey, if a dot presents itself in the upper right-hand corner, very quick, very fast, you know this is a high selling, so we've sold that many amount of, you know, quantity, right? And also how much revenue it's produced, right? That's what we're showing. And of course, naturally, the size of that dot should be linear. It should be large if it's in the upper right-hand quadrant. But we can relabel these, right? You can change this to whatever you like, each of the quadrants. Because depending on your metrics and depending on your data, the upper right might not necessarily be that best quadrant, but you're able to change this to whatever you want. All you do is relabel it here, and it will present itself there inside of the chart in front of you. Naturally, we do have the capability of controlling the X and the Y axis, what is going to be the start and the ending points if we so choose. We naturally can switch this and just put more of a title representation here, or completely turn this off in the bottom if we have a pretty easy understanding of what it is. You are in complete control of what the X as well as the Y axis should be labeled. As well, as you would expect, when we input here within the legend, we have the ability to control which colors represent which of these various different categories. In our case, each of these individual manufacturers. We are in complete control of all of this, and this lends itself very nicely for users to very quickly and effectively understand what are going on with the various different categorical points here, depending on where they fall in which quadrant. And that is definitely the point and the purpose of a visual, to be quick, effective, and very attractive looking as well. So hopefully you enjoyed this video. If you have any questions about this visual or need a similar business solution, feel free to contact MAQ Software at sales@maqsoftware.com. As well, for any of your Power BI training needs, be sure to reach out to us at Pragmatic Works by emailing training@pragmaticworks.com. Take care.